Well, this is obviously an incredibly sad, heartbreaking situation. It's also very confusing for a lot of people. So let's start off by talking about some of the terms here. Brain death. Brain death is not the same as being in a coma or a vegetative state. Brain death, by definition, is irreversible. Now, in the United States and most places, it is legally synonymous with death, the same as if your heart stops. But brain death means a total loss of brain activity. Now, to determine it, doctors will often do several things. A physical exam, for example, shine light into the pupils and see, do they dilate, do they move and constrict? Gently rub the eyeball with some cotton and see if the eye reacts that way. Sometimes they'll put ice water into the ears and see if the eyes move in a particular fashion. These are all tests of the brain stem. They'll also do something known as an apnea test. That means they turn off the ventilator for several minutes and see if the person shows any signs of breathing on their own. As confirmation, oftentimes they'll do scans to check to see if there's blood flow to the brain and also test to see if there's electrical activity from the brain. But again, it's that detailed clinical neurological exam that is so important. Now, coma, if it goes on for an extended period of time, is called a vegetative state. And there's a fair amount of interesting research in this area. In a rare handful of cases, for example, people who have been in a vegetative state for years have returned to some level of consciousness. This is rare, but it does happen. But again, brain death is something else entirely. There is no activity in the brain. There is no blood flow to the brain. It is a grim situation, but again, something that a trained doctor can pretty easily diagnose. Back to you.